NVIDIA claims that the newest driver brings huge speed improvements when you are using the AI. It is claimed that the newest driver brings huge performance with ONNX runtime. Automatic1111 Web UI supports ONNX models with TensorRT. So today I am going to compare this newest driver with basic installation and also TensorRT ONNX models. I am going to do testing on the RTX 3090 Ti on Windows 10. I am going to compare NVIDIA drivers 552 versus 555, which is the latest driver. All tests are compared on both drivers. I am going to do testing on fresh Automatic1111 Web UI installation. I am going to test the speed with the latest Torch version and the xFormers version. Moreover, I will install TensorRT and test and repeat the testing on TensorRT generated model, and we will see the speed differences between older driver, newer driver, between default and TensorRT model. Make sure to watch the entire tutorial because it is super important. For fresh installation, I will use my installer script. So let's use this folder extract here. Just let's install. This installer will install everything automatically for us, including downloading the VAE Fixit SDXL base model and the very best styles. So the installation has been completed and the web UI started. Let's see the default downloaded models. Let's try the default speed. Okay, photo of an amazing sports car. The very best sampler that I am finding is UniPC. Let's make it 40 steps. Change the resolution to the default resolution. So the initially I will do a warm-up generation, then I will generate 4 images to see the speed. This is the default installation. You see version 1.9.3, Python 3.10.11, Torque version is 2.1.2, xFormers is 0.0.23, and the image is generated. To see the speed, I will pause the video and generate images. Okay, 4 images are generated. The IT per second is 3.42. So what is my GPU and my driver right now? To show you that, I will use nvitop. You can use this with pip install nvitop. My driver version is 55.1.23. CUDA version is 12.4. The GPU model is not shown in the nvitop. So this is the GPU versions that I have. NVIDIA SMI command 3090 Ti. So with default fresh installation, the speed is 3.42 for this driver. Now I am going to update my installation to the latest Torque version and xFormers. To do that, I will use the this.bat file. It will update my installation to the latest. For the speed comparison, the CPU also matters. This is my CPU 3090K. This is the frequency it is working right now. Also, my memory is 64 GB and 2500 MHz DDR4. The version updater will show you this error, but it is not important because it will automatically fix it. Yes, fix it and the installation completed. So let's start again our web UI with this bat file. You can also start it from the web UI user.bat file here. Okay, the latest version started. You will also notice that this updater installed the one of the very best extension after detailer latest version. So now the Torch version is 2.3.0 and xFormers is 0.0.26. So let's generate the warm-up image with the same settings. Let's set them up and let's generate. Let's see the nvitop status while generating. You see this is the nvitop displayed parameters, the watt usage, the GPU utilization, the memory utilization, and the warm-up image is generated. Now let's try the actual speed. The generation speed looks like not changed. You see the same speed. Probably for this NVIDIA driver to be effective, we need TensorRT. So now I am going to install TensorRT extension and generate TensorRT model to calculate its speed. And after this, I will update my NVIDIA driver to the latest version and I will repeat the test. So we will see the speed difference. Okay, the TensorRT installed. Then let's restart the web UI. In the initial run of TensorRT installation, it may take a while, just patiently wait. Okay, during the initial installation, you will also get this error. Unfortunately, TensorRT developers still didn't fix this error, but we will fix it. So just click OK to these errors. Okay, 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 then it will start. And the web UI started with TensorRT. Now I will show you how to fix that annoying pop-ups. So close the web UI, then run the TensorRT installer one more time like this, and it is done. Then start the web UI again. So after doing that, you will not see that error anymore. While starting your web UI, you see it is getting started. No errors and started. For TensorRT to work, we need to generate TensorRT. Make sure that you have selected your model, which one you want to generate TensorRT. And I will use this batch size 1 static. Actually, I am going to change this. So the mean batch size 1, optimal batch size 1, let's say maximum batch size 4. It depends on you. You can set the minimum height, whichever you want, like this. Okay, let's also set this, like this. And prompt, this is important. Let's make the optimal prompt like 150 and let's make the maximum 225. Okay, so then export engine. To see the status, you should check out the CMD window. It may take a while depending on your GPU model. In the CMD window, it doesn't show anything. However, in the NVI tab, I can see that it is using GPU. GPU utilization increases or decreases. So it is working. You can also see the memory usage of the GPU. After a while, you will start seeing messages like this. It is working and progressing. Okay, the model generation has been completed. You can see that TensorRT engines has been saved to the disk. It took around 6 minutes, a little bit longer perhaps, and we can see exported successfully. To be able to use it, we need to go to the settings, and in here search for quick. You will see this part and type here Unet, and you will see SD Unet, apply settings. Don't worry, you will also get this message and reload UI. Now we have SD Unet, and in here we can select none, which will use the default unit of the model, or we can use the unit of the realistic vision, which we are going to use. This is the TensorRT model, and let's use the same prompt. This doesn't change quality, but this increases the speed significantly. However, this takes time to compile, but compiling is only one time, and it is ready. And let's generate the initial warm-up. We can see that it is loading the TensorRT unit and the generation started. So this is the initial warm-up generation while recording video. Okay, now it is time to test. So I'm going to make batch count 4. So the test has been completed. We can see that now we are getting 5.51 IT per second. This is almost the speed of 4090. So the speed increases like this, minus 3.41 over 3.41, we got 61.5% speed increase without any quality change, quality loss, quality difference. Now I am going to install the NVIDIA driver to see the difference. I am going to install the latest version of NVIDIA driver. So how we are going to download it? Download NVIDIA drivers, because I see that some people are having issues. So go to here, select your GPU model, it is this one, and yes, I am using game ready driver. Let's search, it is working better, I think. Download, and download should start. If it doesn't start, yeah, we need to click here download, and the download started. So from driver version 55.1, I am going to 55.5. okay, it is downloaded. So all we need to do is run as administrator, click yes when it is asking, and click OK. I am going to show you the selection that I am making. NVIDIA graphics driver, agree and continue, custom, advanced, and I am going to perform a clean installation. Now I will just do next, but before doing that, I am going to turn off the video recording and I will restart computer and we will return back. Okay, so I have installed the latest driver and restarted the system. You can see the newest CUDA driver version and driver version here, and let's make a warm-up test. And let's see the result. So after the warm-up, I have generated 4 images, and we can see that we have a significant speed drop from 3.41 IT per second to 3.27 IT per second. Let's see the TensorRT speed, because this is what I wonder. So let's just change the batch size to 1 and do the initial warm-up. You should watch the messages here. When doing the TensorRT optimization, the xFormers gets disabled. So the TensorRT works, and yes, we can see the speed right now. So here are the speeds after generating 4 images. We got a speed drop after the newest drivers. NVIDIA is disappointing us. I don't know why, Before ending this video, I will also test the optimization of the PyTorch itself. So you see there are different optimizations here. Let's try the SDP. This is the optimization of the PyTorch as far as I know. Let's see the speed of generation. Okay, this one is even slower than the xFormers. I'm going to test these other ones as well. Let's see which one will perform best. This other one was even slower. Let's see the doggettx. This is the latest one. So this is it. It is not always best to upgrade NVIDIA drivers. Unfortunately, currently this new driver didn't bring me any speed increase for some reason. If you get speed increase, let me know. But the TensorRT is working amazing, so you should use it if you are going to generate a lot of images on the same model. Hopefully see you in another amazing tutorial.